Welcome to Hendricks Chapel. This is the spiritual heart of Syracuse University. Today we present Music and Message. This is a weekly series that features musical performances and spoken reflection from diverse religious and spiritual perspectives. We gather for Music and Message every Sunday afternoon at 4 p.m. throughout the academic year. As we begin, I acknowledge with respect the Onondaga Nation, firekeepers of the Haudenosaunee, the indigenous people on whose ancestral lands Syracuse University now stands. My name is Brian Conkle. I serve as Dean of Hendricks Chapel, and thank you all for being with us, whether it's in person or online for this broadcast. This is really a delight. We give thanks for those participating in our program today. The Hendricks Chapel Choir, directed by Dr. Pepe Calvar, and today also Riley McCurdy, Annie Laver, and Abby Wood, serving as organists today, and of course, the Syracuse University Brass Ensemble, directed by James Spencer. As always, we give thanks for Alex Snow, Julie Cajola, the staff of Hendricks Chapel, as well as Brian and Logan Simons from Sensational Events, who not only provide hospitality for those in person here at the chapel, but also work to bring this program virtually to thousands of students, faculty, staff, and alumni through our broadcast. And finally, it must be shared that we are grateful to Dr. Annie Laver and Dr. Pepe Calvar from the Settner School of Music for their ongoing leadership each and every week of this beautiful program. So to all gathered, whether you're in person here or online, we do thank you for being with us. Our hope and our prayer each and every week that Music and Message stirs the hearts and minds that inspire us to sing during the storms of life so that we can bring some joy to our world. So thank you so much for being here. God bless you, and please enjoy.
Thank you. Send the divine. Thank you. Good afternoon. First of all, let me express my sincere thanks and the thanks of the SU Brass Ensemble's members to Dean Brian Conkle, to Dr. Annie Laver, and Dr. Pepe Calvar for the opportunity to be part of today's program. The chapel is definitely at the heart of the ensemble, and we enormously appreciate being both a permanent part of the chapel and being here today. The members of this ensemble overwhelmingly are composed of faculty, staff, students, alumni, and family of alumni, and are passionate both about their music making with the ensemble, but also in their role as visible reminders and representatives of the university and the chapel to the broader community. We come from many different backgrounds, areas of expertise, and professions. Doctors, lawyers, scientists, engineers, teachers, designers, and many, many more. And universities are, of course, similarly composed of a rich diversity of people, thoughts, and pursuits. And it is this diversity that provides much of our strength, perspective, and resilience. The past 3 years have certainly been a challenge for this group, like most organizations, and we're still struggling to navigate. Our recent journey through the past couple of years reminds me of a story that I enjoyed. And I seriously doubt whether it's true, but nonetheless, it remains a good story. The story goes that Albert Einstein, the great physicist and Time magazine's man of the 20th century, was once traveling from Princeton on a train, when the conductor came down the aisle punching the tickets of every single passenger. And when he came to Dr. Einstein, Einstein reached into his vest pocket, and he couldn't find his ticket. So he reached in his other pocket. Wasn't there either. So he looked in his briefcase. It was not there. He looked on the seat beside him, and he just couldn't find it. Does this sound familiar? I'm beginning to relate to this more and more. The conductor, observing all this, said, "Dr. Einstein, it's okay. We know who you are. We all know who you are. I am sure you bought a ticket. Don't worry about it." And Einstein nodded appreciatively, and the conductor continued down the aisle, punching tickets. And as he was ready to move to the next car, he turned around and saw the great physicist down on his hands and knees looking under the seat for his ticket. And the conductor rushed back and said, "Dr. Einstein, don't worry. I know who you are. No problem. You don't need a ticket. I'm sure you bought one." And Einstein looked at him and said, "Young man, I too know who I am. What I don't know is where I'm going." Unfortunately, there's no train ticket that can tell us exactly where we are going. But what we do know is it will be a journey to savor, with unexpected turns and twists to contend with, things to puzzle over. But ultimately, we can rejoice in the beauty of the trip with our hopes bright for the future. Our final piece today, called Vita Aeternum by Paul Lovett Cooper, is just one such message of hope. Vita Aeternum translates into eternal life, and the work is inspired by three Salvation Army songs. I hope you like it. Thank you again for this opportunity to be here today, and we look to the future for opportunities to join together, often and meaningfully.
Thank you.